Give me Larry David in the debauched,
This is Larry speaking.
Hey, man.
Hey.
Want to do something?
Absolutely.
Really? You free?
Yeah, I can be free.
Grab a quick coffee.
Let's get some coffee.
Today, my guest is Larry David. Larry and I have been friends for over 30 years, and we did a TV series together in the 90s.
What the hell, man?
I always loved this car.
Really?
Always.
You excited?
I wouldn't say I'm excited, but I'm looking forward to it. My mother used to say to me once a week,
Larry, why can't you get excited about something? You're never excited. Nothing excites you. Right, we're going to the Irvington Hotel in New Jersey. They have ice skating here. No, I'm not excited.
You know, it's one of your great theories. Each generation gets better looking.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, that's really good observant and original thinking. It's a miracle we ever got any work done, because nobody can waste time like you and me.
Well,
just it waste is, it.
It is a miracle.
It's a miracle.
I agree.
One of the things that the comedian mindset requires is laziness.
Absolutely.
You don't want to do real work.
No, no. I always wanted the show to get canceled, so I didn't have to work. I don't like driving a stick.
That was very Jewish.
Well, I'm Jewish. And you know what? I could be described as very Jewish.
I gotta turn on the wipers here, watch this.
Yeah. Holy cow.
Isn't that hilarious? I like cars that feel like toys.
I was looking to buy one.
Really?
Yeah.
When was this?
This is like 5 years ago.
5 years ago. I knew it was 5 years ago.
It's always 5 years ago.
It's always 5 years ago.
The lunch at a normal American restaurant is very problematic for me.
Piece of fish?
I don't like to have hot food for lunch. Yeah, a salad.
Yeah.
But it's not much in the salad.
What do you love?
For lunch?
Yeah.
I usually have a salad for lunch. And then I have a protein shake.
Wow. Where do you get that?
Get in a store. The answer was equally as stupid as the question.
I don't understand that there's nothing you could eat.
People are disturbed by it. My ex-wife hated it. I think that's one of the reasons we our marriage ended.
She couldn't take the way you eat.
You know, because I stopped drinking coffee.
Right.
And she hated it. I said, what do you care? I had tea in the cup.
Yeah.
She said, well, we can't even share coffee in the morning anymore. I said, but there's something in my cup. What? You can't see into my cup. I'm still sipping. There's still steam coming out of it.
Right.
What's the difference?
I know. I ordered soup the other day. Somebody said, that's all you're gonna get? What the hell do you care? But look at the turn signal.
Holy mackerel.
It's called a semaphore.
I thought a semaphore was some grammatical notation.
That's a semicolon.
I'm gonna look that up. Just made the distance that was acceptable for me to hold that door.
Thank you. I would like a cup of coffee.
I'll have an herbal tea.
Do you remember those bowls of cereal I used to eat?
Still do that?
No.
When did this happen?
Five years ago.
Hey, look, I've got it in a cup. You don't know what it is.
Well, bully for you.
So if this is tea rather than coffee, a person should find that so disturbing?
I'm sorry that you're not going to like what I'm about to say, but I'm afraid your wife has a bit of a point.
Really?
Yes.
There's a point. Look, I can talk just as well holding this cup as if there were coffee in it. What's the difference?
You want to know the difference?
Yeah, I do.
We go to an ice cream shop. I get a cone. And you get a salad. That's the difference. And you go, what? I'm eating, you're eating. It's the mood. Who could say what creates mood? Mood is a thing that's just there. The only reason we know it's there is that we feel it. You're giving me a scientific argument that I can't combat.
What's funny about that?
I don't know.
Dietarily, you're a master.
I'm not a master.
No?
No. I have snacking problems.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Give me the circumstances of...
When do I go off?
When you go off. Give me Larry David in the debauch... The debauched...
Oh, Jesus.
Why do you love that word?
I don't know. It's a great word.
It's a funny word. What's that guy's name? What's the penthouse guy?
Guccione.
It's a Bob Guccione word.
You know, a lot of people think it's just debauchery. A real spit take is not often. You don't get that often, right?
Probably 5 years since I've seen one.
Yeah. All right, so when am I going to let my guard down? When am I going to eat like a human?
When do you go out of control?
Out of control is two pieces of pizza, right?
Right.
Never two.
Heat doesn't have any flavor.
It's inviting.
Why? What does it do?
It warms you. That's very Kramerish. It's good, Jerry. Heat. It warms you.
Anything you say with a cigar just sounds so much better.
It imbues you with knowledge.
What is it about it?
There's something contemplative about it.
Why not a cigarette?
The cigarette isn't contemplative. It's not that. The cigarette is that.
Right.
It's anxiety. There's anxiety associated with it. You know what I mean?
Right.
Whereas the cigar is relaxing. And when you relax, you're open to more thoughts. You have time to think.
The cigar takes time.
Cigar takes time.
That's the key to it. That's the whole key. Someone smoking a cigar is in no hurry.
Absolutely. You're in no hurry at all.
Right.
Whereas the cigarette smoker...
Yeah.
Rushed. Gotta get out, you know.
But a cigarette takes some time.
Yes, I know, but... A cigarette is just... It's just... It's not something you're enjoying.
You continue to have one of the finest minds I've ever met.
Coming from you, I take that as a great compliment.
From day one, this guy's got some head on him. That cigarette thing, I love that. Here's an analysis of something by two idiots that no one else is doing.
You have finally done the show about nothing.
What underwear do you wear?
I'm still briefs.
Really?
Yep.
Briefs over 60.
Yes, I couldn't make the transition.
Well, now they have a thing called a boxer brief, which is what I wear.
Yeah.
Which is a brief but has a little leg to it.
Uh-huh.
And it's very nice when that's all you around the house, you know. You feel comfortable going from the bedroom to the kitchen in the boxer brief.
Uh-huh.
Whereas you may not. Do you?
Oh, no, I know you
can't. Do you parade at all?
No, you cannot parade with briefs. Yeah.
Does it say on the box? Is it a little parade with a line through it? Do not parade.
Caution.
Caution.
Parading is not recommended.
In this garment.